Welcome to Abu Dhabi. We're just about to start today's race here at the Yas Marina Circuit. It's a track known for its long, long back straight, which serves as a fantastic opportunity for overtaking, going into the slow speed corners that follow it. The Yas Marina Circuit is made up of 3.28 miles of track, featuring 16 corners with two very long straights. DRS zones going into the heavy braking zones of both turn 5 and turn 7 offer plenty of potential for overtaking. The circuit comes with its fair share of tricky corners, which will certainly test a driver's braking management. So with the race not far away from starting, here's what today's grid rundown looks like. Max Verstappen put in a fantastic lap yesterday, and he'll start from pole position. Sergio Perez lines up alongside. Considering the rest of the grid, we have Leclerc, Hamilton, Carlos Sainz, and Russell, Norris, Fernando Alonso, Ocon, and Guan Yu Zhou, Gasly, Bottas, Kevin Magnussen, and Vettel, Mick Schumacher, Tsunoda, Lance Stroll, and Alex Albon. Latifi and Daniel Ricciardo fills the last spot on the grid. It's almost time for the lights to go out, so let's head down to the track where preparations are underway. Anthony Davidson joins me once again in the commentary box. Ant, it's fantastic to have you with us here, but I'm curious, as a man with experience out on the track, how do you stop those pre-race nerves from becoming overwhelming when you're lining up on the grid?
Well, I imagine they'll be starting to feel the adrenaline as they anticipate the rundown into turn one, a bit like preparing to go into battle. The unknown situation will bring nerves, but that's a good thing. It will keep them focused on the moment and on their surroundings as we build towards the start of the Grand Prix.
We'll be right back.
Another Abu Dhabi Grand Prix is over then, and what a special race this was. And talk to me, what do you think it was that sealed the win for them?
Well, this was a real team victory. They put together a solid strategy today that appeared well suited to the conditions out on track. The driver did everything that was expected of them in the moment to really execute the team's plan to perfection, a shining example of how F1 really is a team sport.
Here come today's winners. The team at Red Bull have done a phenomenal job recently, and it's clear to see that they've put in the work, and they should be so proud of the victory they secured here.